Hello, good morning, students. How are you all? Fine? Yes, so we are almost in the pisciculture. I have done about the pisciculture, that's about the fisheries, inland fisheries, capture fisheries. We have done it, right? Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, all of you. Naveshri, good morning. Romana, everybody. Okay, fine. Okay. So we started with the types of fisheries and I told you how to maintain the fish ponds, right? Actually, man-made pond is the one aquarium. But apart from that, real fisheries happens only in the nature. Capture fisheries only go and catch it. And I told you how inland fishery is done. Inland fishery, where you are going to first take the eggs, allow them to hatch in hatchery ponds, then you are allowing them to produce or grow and they form fingerlings. Fingerlings are transferred to the next one where they will become larger sized and they get mated, and after that that is called as a collection pond. After that they will preserve them. Okay, this is fisheries, right? Now we are going to talk about the types of fishes. First, we are going to talk about the marine fishes. Then, we are going to talk about the fishes that are available in freshwater. So, freshwater fishes, I hope you know. Rohu, Katla, and Mrigala, all those things. Okay. Then, the marine fishes are Pamphlet is there, Bombay duck is there. Okay. So, I think you are writing that point, you write and finish that first. Okay? Write down the various or common marine fishes. There only we stopped yesterday. Marine fishes. Are you writing? And yesterday I told you how to maintain the fish ponds. Culturing the plant, the fishes. Okay. Name of the freshwater marine water fishes. Yeah, we were talking about that only. I'm just waiting for all of them to get in. Just now it's time. You can tell me the marine fishes are called pomfrets, Bombay duck, hilsa, sardine, right? And the freshwater ones are katla, rohu, mrigala. Okay, I'll write it on the board. Not this one. This is about the first PC part. You know it. Just now I finished the first PC class. Now I'm taking for you. So first PC diagram is still on the board. Okay. Let's begin with the types of fishes. Types of fishes. First one, marine fishes. These are Bombay duck, pomfret, sardine, tuna, then freshwater fishes, fishes are rohu, katla. Here you will get hilsa also, hilsa here, right? Mrigal, रगर एंड चितल चीताल. So these are the types of fishes which are commonly available in sea water and in your fresh water. Okay, so write the heading types of fishes, take them down, take their names. Are you writing? Then, okay. Okay, finished. Okay, now listen. We'll talk about one more thing which we have not done is about the sheep and goats. Actually, that is there required for your syllabus in NEET. Okay, I'll give you the various types of sheep and goats what are there in India. Okay, so actually, sheep are called ovis aries. Right, sheep and goats. It has to be done after cattle. Then anyway, sheep and goats are only for meat. In regular world, it is not there. So just for the extra information, I am giving you. Right? Sheep and goats. Okay. So sheep are biologically called ovis aries. Ovis aries is the name of sheep, and goats are called as are called Capra hircus. Hircus. Capra hircus. Okay, that's about the sheep and goats, right? Actually, sheep and goats are required for meat and therefore skin and therefore milk, because it produces very thick milk. And sheep milk also is so important in other villages. Now they will drink sheep milk itself. So that is why we are going to learn about the sheep and goats. Then Indian varieties of sheep and goats, I'll give their names later. You write it. Write the heading. Sheep and goats. Sheep are biologically called ovis aries. Sheep are biologically called ovis aries. And goats are called Capra hircus. Sheep are important because of their wool, skin, and mutton. Sheep provide Our sheep are important for their wool, skin and mutton. And goats provide milk, meat, skin and hair. The softest wool. Which is softest wool is produced by pashmina, which is common in Kashmir and Tibet. Very thick wool. Pashmina is very costly also. You have seen pashmina sweaters and scarves and all very costly. So they are grown only in this area. It is because of their wool, which is thick and very warm type of woolen cloth produced from this. Okay, right on. Pashmina is one of the softest wool produced by sheep's grown in Kashmir. Sorry, by goats of Kashmir and Tibet. Kashmir and Tibet. Goats of Kashmir and Tibet. Next, right? Some Indian breeds of sheep. Indian breeds of sheep. Sheep variety, some of the Indian sheeps. Indian breeds of sheeps. Okay. One is Nali. So first one I'm talking about the sheeps. Sheeps breed. Breeds of Indian breeds of sheeps. Nali. Second one, Rampur. Third one, Lohi. Next is Nellore. Okay, that's about the sheep breeds. And one of the, some of the goats I'll give you. Some of the goat varieties, goats. First one is Gaddi or Chamba. Both are same. Gaddi or Chamba. Second one is Kashmiri and Pashmina. Kashmiri and Pashmina. Both are same. Pashmina. Next is Beetle. Okay, 1, 2, 3 only names you can remember, which are really common. Next is Marwari. Marwari na Marwari na, you know, Marwari. Okay. Even in this, there is one Marwari variety. Marwari they call it. Write down these varieties and their origin place you write. Right, Nali. Nali is from Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan. Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan. Important for its superior carpet wool. Superior carpet wool. Important for its superior carpet wool. Are you writing? I am not observing anybody saying anything. Carpet wool. Next one, Rampur. It's in UP and Himachal Pradesh. Used, it is used for its brown colored fur. Brown colored fur for superior cloth. For superior cloth. I hope you have seen many people will wear such things, right? Cloth with a brown fur. That's from Rampur. Next, Lohi is from Punjab and Rajasthan. It is used for good quality of wool and milk. Wool and milk. Nellore. Nellore is from Maharashtra. Somebody was saying Andhra. Actually, Nellore is from Maharashtra. Nellore, not L-U-R, L-O-R. Nellore from Maharashtra. It produces good quality of mutton. Good quality of mutton. Okay. Means for the meat it is. Next. Goats, you write. Gaddi or Chamba. It's from Himachal Pradesh. Useful for milk. Next. Kashmiri and Pashmina. Himachal Pradesh, Kashmir and Tibet. Gaddi place, that only I am writing. Gaddi is Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh. Kashmir and Pashmina is also Himachal Pradesh, Kashmir and Tibet. Nellore place and use, I told you, no, Nitish, Nellore place and use, let me know, Nellore is from Maharashtra, used for good quality of mutton, means meat. I repeated, Nitish, good quality of meat or mutton. Okay, next in memory, Gaddi or Chamba and Dauru. Yerad variety of Adano. Gaddi and Chamba, they are from Himachal Pradesh for milk. Second one, Kashmiri and Pashmina are from Himachal Pradesh, Kashmir and Tibet. High quality of wool. Beetle is from Punjab. For milk. Marwari is from Rajasthan. For milk. Okay. Next we'll talk about the apiculture. Okay. Apiculture. Have you written all? Okay. Finish that. Okay. Listen. Now we'll talk about the apiculture. Apiculture is growing of the honeybees. Apis indica, we call it honeybee, right? Apis indica, why we are talking about honeybees? Hardly we people know, we never grow honey anything. We are not growing honeybees for the commercial purpose, right? But actually it is a very good profession to start with. It is like a business you can start it. Apiculture is a technique of growing the honeybees in a honeycomb artificially in our own backyard. You can grow, right? Most of the time, apiculture, but there are technology, there is a technique for how to handle them. That's what we call it. We study under the heading apiculture. So, apiculturally, we grow these for and take out the honey from that. So honey is a most important fluid or liquid which is rich in fructose. Apart from that, it is rich in a lot of vitamins also, right? Therefore honey is useful. Apart from that, there is a wax produced by the honeycomb. Actually they produce wax to avoid releasing of the liquid honey from the honeycomb. Honeycomb is the nearly leave our bones and the wax they are made. From its body part. That wax they will apply. That wax is very good from the honeycomb. The wax is extracted and they prepare a lot of creams and Vaseline from the honey bee wax. Bee wax, we call it bee wax. Bee wax and all our known how they produce in the honey comb to come to the extract matter wax. So mostly it is good in for the cosmetic industry they use it, right? Cosmetics alella honey wax use matre. For example, animal origin bee wax is used in lipsticks. Yes, bee wax is used in lipsticks. And remember one thing, all of you, most of the lipsticks that are cheaper variety, they don't use bee wax. The costly varieties only they have bee wax, because bee wax is very costly. Most of the other lipsticks which you take very low cost, they are made up of the pig fat and matter. Pig fat and then they put lipstick matter. Don't think always bee wax is used for the lipsticks. Okay, lipsticks ge usually pig dud use matare, along with that they make it whale fat in the produce matare. They used in furniture ma meega anta gothagilla prakriti. Furniture polishing use martara, are dolu maybe furniture polishing use maarbodu. Okay, yeah, right. Then coming to the types of honeybees, right? Honeybees in the varieties ide namage ಒಂದೊಂದು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ರೈಟ್ ಐ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ದ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಹನಿ ಬೀಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ನೀಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇವನ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓಕೆ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದೇ ಓಕೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಏಪಿಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಕಾ Now we are going to talk about the apiculture. Right? Apiculture is the technique of growing the honeybees in backyard or anywhere you want. Right? The types of honeybees: Apis indica, the Indian small bee. Second one, Apis dorsata. The large bee or rock bee we call it. Next one, third one, Apis mellifera, because a small bee. Fourth one, Apis floria or floria, the little bee. Okay, fourth one, Apis adamsoni. It is an African bee. Okay, these are the types of bees we have. Okay, write the heading apiculture. First we'll talk about these names, then we'll go further. Some more things I want to write. Right, apiculture, it is the science of rearing honeybees. It is a science of rearing honeybees for obtaining honey, wax or bee wax and venom tagontare idrinda anti venom madlikke use martare and venom adalli sting iruttalva a sting inda venom nu martare. Okay, I repeat, like apiculture is the science of rearing honey bees for obtaining honey, bee wax and venom is extracted from its sting. Whenever it bites, no, whenever the honeybee bites, it will release the sting. Okay. No. What you have written? Sting. I hope you know. Whenever the honeybees bite, no, they release that sting that is having a lot of kind of venom in it. Right? They use it as, you know, anti-venom preparation. Once I told, no, during immunity, ಹೌದೇ ಬಿಡಿ ಆಂಟಿ ವೆನಮ್ ಆ ತರ ವೆನಮ್ ತಯಾರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಓಕೆ ವೆನಮ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟೇಬಲ್ ಮನಿ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಹಾಬಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟೇಬಲ್ ಮನಿ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಹಾಬಿ There are different types of honeybees. First one, Apis indica. It is the Indian small bee. It's a small Indian bee. It's a small Indian bee. First, I'll give you all. In line, okay. Second one, you write Apis floria, floria, folia, la, floria. Apis floria. Idu yakandre India dido. Adukoskara idu ottige second idine bari. Floria. Apis floria. It is Indian. Little Indian bee. It is the little Indian bee. Apis floria, little Indian bee. Antara. Next, Apis dorsata. It's a giant bee. Giant bee. Giant antara dewa tara iruthe thumba doddiruthide. Giant bee. Next. Imported varieties of honeybee are imported varieties of honeybee are first one Apis mellifera European bee next Apis adamsoni the African bee African bee. Okay, have you written all? I repeat. Listen, I am writing here now. This, let us see. This is the Indian. Bee. This is the Indian giant bee. This is also Indian, but Indian giant bee. This is the Indian small bee. Right? Have you written that? This is Indian. ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಅನ್ನೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಂತ ಇರ್ತದೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಪುಟಾಣಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಚಿಕ್ಕದಿರ್ತದೆ ಇದು ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಬಿ ಇದನ್ನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಇದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ದೊಡ್ಡದಿರುತ್ತೆ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಬಿ ಇದು ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಜೈಂಟ್ ಬಿ ತುಂಬಾ ದೊಡ್ಡದಿರ್ತದೆ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಜೈಂಟ್ ಏಪಿಸ್ ಮೆಲ್ಲಿಫೆರಾ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಯುರೋಪಿಯನ್ ಬಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಎಕ್ಸಾಟಿಕ್ ವೆರೈಟಿ ಅಡಾಮ್ಸೋನಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಆಫ್ರಿಕನ್ ಬಿ ಬರ್ದ ನೋಡಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಅಂತ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ವೆರೈಟೀಸ್ ಮೂರು ಮಟ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎರಡು ಆಫ್ರಿಕನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಯುರೋಪಿಯನ್ ಬಿ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು ಅಲ್ವಾ ಅದೇ ತರ ಬರೆಸಿದೀನಿ ಈಗೇನು ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಅದೊಂದು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯು ರಿಟನ್ ಇಟ್ Okay, done. Okay, finished. Now I'll explain you how is the one bee colony. If in a honey bee colony, if you observe, what are you find, right? Very nice things are there, stories about this. You just listen to me thoroughly. A bit, I think I have told you earlier also. In first PC, our students, I might have told you, but now you understand properly. So, in the honeycomb, right? Honeycomb, we normally get around 40 to 50,000 bees you get. Okay, so many will be there. But these are classified into three types, right? What are the three types? First one is a queen bee, the larger one. Second one is called, they are called the drones. Third one are called the worker bees. Workers, okay? So queen bee is the only female, one or two only will be there in the colony. Hardly one or two will be there in the colony. And this is the one which is ruling the whole honeycomb, right? What it will do is that the queen bee is the only one which can produce the children, right? She's a fertile one. She's a fertile female. And she will rule the whole colony. How I tell you? Drone bees are actually male bees, right? These are around few thousands, right? One or two thousands or more than that, right? But they are, normally they are fertile, but they are normally haploid in nature. They're the haploid bees, right? They have only n number of chromosomes, right? Female is a diploid one, okay? 2n it is. Female is diploid, males are, these are haploids. Worker bees are actually females, and these are fertile, but they have not undergo fertilization. Fertile, they are diploid in nature, okay? Now, let me tell you the functions of this. Queen bee is going to only produce children, right? She will be fed with a royal honey when it was born. By these workers, we grow this queen bees, right? Workers are all female, they are like mothers for all, right? The queen bees only, they look after the whole the honeycomb and find out if there is anything wrong, right? If there is anything wrong with the honeybee or somebody is coming and all, they will, she will order other people to look after that. But what is drone bee? Drone bee is doing only one thing. It is one of them, little larger one, we call the king bee. That drone will go fertilize the queen bee. And remaining ones, they'll be simply roaming around the honeycomb. And they will be looking after the honeycomb when the females, all the workers are gone to collect the honey. They will not go collect the honey. They'll be simply roaming around the honeycomb. Right? Then comes the worker bees. These are the females. They are the maximum doing workers people. They are like everything they do in the colony. What they'll do is, first they go collect the honey from the various areas. They bring it and they keep it in the honeycomb. And to avoid this draining of this honey, honey is a liquid thing, no? They will, some of the workers will keep beating their wings so that they will dry this honey. Honey dry, but clean maadi dry maadi. That's what is a worker doing. Apart from this, they will clean the honeycomb. Dead things and all, they will remove. Dust particles, everything they remove, they clean the honeycomb. And they will feed everybody, this drones and other things. Queen bee will be demanding it, she will drink it. But these drones will be begging for the honey. Oh, I want some honey, give. Because they don't go collect the honey, na? Very nice it is. The workers will only select and give them honey. Otherwise, drones will be simply roaming around in the colony or in the honeycomb. Right? The workers will provide the honey to others also. They look after the young ones. When the queen bee produce children, they will do caring, nursing and all. They'll clean and they grow them, they feed them, everything they do, the young ones, right? Then one thing, these are also fertile, sometimes they may become queens. But what happens is when these people have gone out for flying and bringing the honey, the queen bee roams around in that area, produce a kind of scent, which make these unfertile, right? Very clever she is. She will never give chance for others to become queens, right? She will produce some kind of a hormone in that area so that the workers, females, will never get fertile. Very nice it is, right? So that's how the queens are poisoning the area, right? You know this, I think. Fine. Let's write about the work, how they do it in the whole honeycomb. How they work and extract honey. Right? Let's study. Right on. Queen bee dies, who will be, there'll be, yeah, that's a nice question. Actually, there'll be one small bee, they will keep it as a reserve. The newborn ones, no? Suppose there'll be one female is there, small one, they'll keep one or two bees extra, right? That time they will start feeding them royal honey and make them queens. That's a good question. Okay, right on. Social organization of honeybee. Right on. Social organization of honeybee. Like termites. Honeybees are social insects. For producing honey and wax. A highly organized division of labor is found in colony of honeybees. Found in a colony of honeybees. Where is Sri Gauri? I'm not able to see. She is there. Sri Gauri is there. Samyak is not seen today. Vidya, okay, next. In a well-developed colony, there are around 40 to 50,000 bees. In well-developed colonies, there are around 40 to 50,000 bees found. There also, yeah, very good, baby. Samyak, good. See, understand how nicely they work. Actually, it's very surprising to see how the person would have studied all this. Somebody would have studied, you know, all these things. Eh? You should go and study every bee, how are they? Okay, Samir, fine, good. But you are so silent in the class. Right? Actually, in the regular class, you'll be talking and responding. And here you are very silent, baby. Okay, next. 40 to 50,000 individuals. And they are classified into three groups. Okay, that's good. They are classified into three groups. First one, queen. Second one, drone. Third one, worker. Queen, drone, and worker. Right heading, the queen. It's a well-developed fertile female. With a large number of ovaries in it. Commonly, there is a single queen bee in each hive. Is present in each hive. and it feeds on royal jelly. ಅದೇದಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಜೆಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತೆ ಅವಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕುಡಿತದೆ ಅದು ಬೇರೆವೆಲ್ಲ ಬೇರೆ ಊಟ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬೇರೆ ಊಟ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ರಾಯಲ್ ಜೆಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಬೀಸ್ largest among all the bees that is 15 to 20 millimeter in length adhe dodudu dodudu ane tara iralla 15 to 20 millimeter in length she is unable to produce wax or honey She is unable to produce wax or honey. Or to collect the nectar. She is unable to produce wax or honey, but and unable to collect the nectar. Okay, listen, I'll tell you how she will do. Ma'am, won't be the bee starved to death? Starved to death, antala, they will go and start making the honeycomb in other areas. Okay, listen, let me tell you about the queen bee story. I told you, queen bee will be the largest. Okay, it's dotta abdomen is there. Okay, and the end will be slightly curved like this. In here, maybe in here, then we will get the number. Okay, in here, we will get the queen bee. Okay, insect aligning. In here, this honey bee, there is one sting. In here, this sting, there is one sting. In here, this sting. In here, this will be storing the eggs. She will produce 200-300 eggs because the ovipositor. Positor. Andre eggs na alli ittukondirutte. Normally what happens is drones, no? Male, one of the king, it will fertilize the female, the queen, and she will produce lot of eggs. And what happens is whenever it has to produce the drones, she will not allow the sperms produced or they will be stored in this area. These are the sperms. Okay, whenever she has to produce the eggs, release the eggs, she will allow the sperms to enter into the eggs, fertilize them and release them. They will grow as a fertilized females. On fertilization of the male and female gamete, there will be formation of workers. Therefore, they grow as the females. But whenever it has to produce drones, then she will close this sperm depositor. Only eggs are released without fertilization. Only egg is released. This egg is released. This will be haploid. This will grow into males, right? Or the drones. So very clever she will behave. Whenever it has to produce the females, she will allow the sperms. All the sperms are deposited in its body. They'll be allowed to fertilize the egg, then it'll produce the females or the workers. Whenever there is no need for the workers, only drones have to be produced, then she will release the eggs unfertilized. And then we call this as parthenocarpy, right? Parthenocarpy producing the males without, so they are produced unfertilized eggs, unfertilized. Egg produce this is by parthenocarpy. So this way of parthenocarpy producing the drones without fertilization is called as arhenotoke. Double R. Arhenotoke is the method. Workers form out of the fertilization algorithm. That's a diploid structure. Okay? Did you understand this? Here questions na here are questions kaise hota hai there is no 50% chance of males and female sex in humans. There is no 50% chance of males and sex in humans. Sangathre sanjay na karta hai na correct hai bari aim barte hai I didn't understand here Sanjay. Okay, write down. Only one person can understand. Next, write. Queen bee possesses a ovipositor. Ovipositor. Egg na itkoru do ovipositor na thara. Bondo. Sun na chamber the itke ovipositor na thara. Ovipositor. Even 50% chance of baby to male or female. How though? Okay. Humans are 50% chance. But either lane cutting. Why are you telling me that now? I don't understand the relation between that and this. Human reproduction hair coating in a fine. Sex determination Sanjay. Is it relevant here? I don't know, right? I don't think it's a relevant thing you are talking about. Okay, write on. Okay, what you have written? The queen bee contains an ovipositor with a small sting in it. Where eggs are stored and they are laid from this organ. Okay, fine, no issues. Okay, Sanjay. Next, right? Ovipositor with a sting where eggs are stored and eggs are laid. It also contains a spermatheca, a pouch for storing sperms. It also possesses a spermatheca, a pouch for storing sperms. Next, during mating, queen bee get the sperms from the drones. Get sperms from the drones. Full stop. Each drone releases around 2 crores of sperms. Each drone releases around 2 crores of sperms. During one mating, this is enough for the queen to produce offsprings throughout life. Enough for the female to produce offsprings throughout life. The yard crow release madidre idi jeevanakella bekagira sperm sirutte anta. Next. One queen lays around. One queen lays around 1,500 to 2,000 eggs in a day. Are you writing? All of you? Yes, okay, Sanjay. How many eggs in a day she will produce, queen? Okay. Then now listen. It will live for 2 to 3 years. So in 3 years, how many eggs she will lay? Ashtana, 6,000. 3 years, 1 dinakke 1,500. 3 varshakke eshtu? ಬರೀ 6,000 ಪ್ರಕೃತಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಗೌರಿ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 16 lakh ಎಗ್ಸ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ 16 lakh ಓಕೆ ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ದಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹೋಲ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸ್ಪ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಫ್ 2 to 3 years ಶಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಲೇ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 15 lakhs ಟು 16 lakh ಎಗ್ಸ್ 15 lakhs 15 lakhs to 16 lakh eggs. Done? Okay, listen now. You are asking me what happens if at all the queen bee dies. So after this 2 to 3 years, it gets old. Its reproduction capacity decreases. Then what happens? One of the young female will be started feeding, others will start feeding with royal honey to convert it into queen. So all they are very organized. They don't have to compete also. They'll be doing all that. Right on. When the queen bee loses its capacity of reproduction, another female worker bee of the same colony is fed with royal jelly and it develops into a new queen bee. Sanjay, doubt how it is? Sanjay, get new queen bee. The old queen bee sometimes will be driven out of the colony. Heltini, Nitish, wait. Old queen bee. Nitish and Tide Yaridu. Nan Nisarga Yara. Yar the bearer number I know. Tamanda and then I bet. Apanda. Maybe. Okay, right up. When queen bee become old, it will be driven out of the colony. But some of the bees, if object, very nice it is. Some of the bees, if object for driving the old bee out, the conflict can be solved. The conflict can be solved by driving all other bees, that are in favor of mother bee. Did you understand what is the story of this? Artha is the story. I repeat. If there is a conflict to drive away, once again I'm changing the words, drive away the queen bee, it is solved as the other bees that in support of old bee, favor of old bee, are also driven away or drive away along with the mother bee. What did you understand in this? Listen, we got new queen bee, Chromartha. Old queen bee, Ajji Abde, Jumya Kuti, Papa. Adre, nobody likes her. Yes. Nobody likes her simply sitting idle. Like that, honey, you go to Marak Varela, Sting Varela, Wax Varela. Adke, and then the other, they're waste of putting it in a words for them. They all try to drive away. But some of them we are in favor of that queen bee, old Thai at the favor. How again, Madre, Jagalad of Beda, we will go along with the mother bee. The mother bee, Jagalad, on the channel, over a very good. So nice, right? Shall be thrown out. Okay, yes, ma'am, when queen bee loses capacity for reproduction, it is thrown out, and the other bees who are in favor of queen shall be thrown out. Correct. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ ಅವನು ಓಡಿಸ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ. ನೀವು ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಅಂತ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಡೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಅಜ್ಜಿ ತಾತ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅನಾಥಾಶ್ರಮ ಸೇರಿಸ್ತಾರೆ, ಹಂಗೆ ಓಡಿಸ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು. ನಮ್ದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ನೇಚರ್, ನಮ್ದ್ರಲ್ಲೇ ನೇಚರ್ ಹಂಗೇನಿಲ್ಲ. ಫಿಲ್ಮ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ತರ ಇದು, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಫಿಲ್ಮ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. ಒಳ್ಳಿಸೋದಿತ್ತ ಓಡಿಸ್ಬಿಡಂದ್ರೆ ಪಾಪ ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಅಂತ ಬೇರೆಯವರೆಲ್ಲ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕೆಲವು ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆಚೆ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಾರೆ. ದೊಡ್ಡ ತಾಯಿನ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಅಂತ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕುಟಿ ಊಟ ತಿಂಡಿ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ಸಣ್ಣದೊಂದು ಹೂವು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಕೂತಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆ. ಸೀರಿಯಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ, ಎಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್, ಸೀರಿಯಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. ಅನಾಥಾಶ್ರಮ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಹಂಗೆ ಇದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಎನಿವೇ, ನಮ್ದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಮನುಷ್ಯತ್ವ ಇದೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೆಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಲುಕ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ಲಿ. ರೈಟ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ನೋ, ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೋಸ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, these new bees along with the old mother establish one new colony, this is called swarming. SWARMING, swarming ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದ ಜನ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿಬಿಡೋದು. ಈಗ ಅಣ್ಣ ತಮ್ಮ ಜಗಳ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಆಗ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಅಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗ್ತಾರಲ್ವಾ. ನನಗೆ ಅಮ್ಮ ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಒಬ್ಬರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಮ್ಮನ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಒಬ್ಬನ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾನೆ, ಅಮ್ಮ ಬೇಡ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಪ್ಪನ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಒಬ್ಬನ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾನೆ. ನಮ್ಮದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಪ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ತಾಯಿ ಬೀನ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ರೈಟ್, ದೇ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಕಾಲನಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್, these new bees along with the mother bee get separated from a new colony. Get separated and form a new colony. And it is called swarming. S-W-A-R-M-I-N-G. Swarming. S-W-A-R-M-I-N-G. Swarming. Okay, next. The drones. Drone category. Drones are the haploid male bees. Drones are the haploid male bees. Which fertilizes the queen? Which fertilizes the queen? They are like kings of the family. They are like kings of the family. They are produced from unfertilized egg. They are produced from unfertilized egg through parthenogenesis. Through parthenogenesis. And it is called Arhenotoki. Now, one such thing is Arhenotoki. Spelling what is it? A double R H E N O T O K Y. Arhenotoki. I say Arhenotoki. A double R, single R, double R. Arhenotoki. Barra. Next one, right? Drones are totally dependent on workers. Drones are totally dependent on workers. And have been seen. And have been seen begging honey from workers. Begging honey from workers. ಕೆಲಸ ಇಲ್ಲ ಖಾಲಿ ಕೂತಾಗ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಮನೇಲಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ನೀವು ಮನೇಲಿ ಏನ್ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ ಮನೇಲೆಲ್ಲ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಡೌನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಅಡಿಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಗ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಪಾಪ ಡ್ರೋನ್ಸ್ ಏನ್ ಕೆಲಸ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬೆಗಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡಿ ನನ್ಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹನಿ ಕುಡಿಯಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ. ರೈಟ್, ಬೆಗಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹನಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವರ್ಕರ್ಸ್. The only duty for drone is to fertilize the queen. The only duty for drone is to fertilize the queen. Okay. The drone that fertilizes the queen normally die after copulation. Normally die. Sathopadukadha amela. After copulation. Copulation aadmele sperms deposit madmele sathopadukadha. Next. The workers. You want me to repeat, Aisha? Write down. The drone after copulation is killed or it died. The whole sentence I will not repeat. Last game meaning back to Barkoli. Then I'll use some of the new words on my own and all like that. In mathematics, this sentence I may change the sentence, but meaning will remain same. Next week, the workers. Workers are in small numbers compared to drones. The workers are smaller in size in the colony. workers are the smaller or smaller in size in the colony, but they do major functions. They do major functions. They collect the honey. They collect the honey, store honey in the honeycomb, store honey in a honeycomb, comma, by beating their wings, by beating their large wings, they dry the honey, and the process called fanning. Okay, inge martala adke fanning antare. Neen jora jora maadi dry maadtare neena, called fanning. FANNING, fanning. Their body contain a pollen basket. Okay, body mail sense baskets li pollen based kon barute pollen baskets, and they collect pollen grains. They also contain a sting. To defend the colony against attack. If somebody comes in, they will sting or in all honey bee in there, sting it. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ದೇ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಫೆಂಡ್ ದ ಕಾಲನಿ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್. ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಅ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಗ್ಲಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಿಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್. ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಅ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಗ್ಲಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಿಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್. Next, next, right? Apiary means how to maintain honeycombs artificially. Apiary, APIARY, apiary. Apiary are the beehives that need to be maintained in an area with more flowering plants. There also should be a clean water body nearby. Clean water body nearby. Because honeybees also require water, around 2 glasses per day. Okay. Next, formation of honey. Formation of honey. Honey is a viscous sugary fluid. Honey is a viscous sugary fluid. Sugary fluid. Formed from the plant nectar. Formed from the plant nectar within the stomach of honeybee. ಅದು ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ತೋಮ ನಿಂಗೆ ಉಳಿಯಲ್ಲ ಅದು ತೋಮ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಲ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಲ್ ಮಾಡಿಫೈ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಟರ್ ವಿದಿನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಮಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಹನಿ ಬೀ ವಿದಿನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಮಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಹನಿ ಬೀ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ The bees visit the flower and suck the nectar. The bees visit the flower and suck the nectar. Store it in the stomach. Store it in the stomach. And return to hives. Return to hives. In stomach, the nectar is processed. In stomach, the nectar is processed. It is continuously regurgitated. Regurgitation and rhythm. It is continuously regurgitated. What is regurgitation? ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೇಲ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಅಂತ ವಾಮಿಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ದಂಗೆ ರಿಗರ್ಜಿಟೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ವಾಲೋಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಅರೆ ರಿಗರ್ಜಿಟೇಷನ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ವಾ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ನಿಸರ್ಗ ರಿಗರ್ಜಿಟೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಮಕ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಹಿಂಗ್ ಚರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಇದು ರಿಗರ್ಜಿಟೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಇ ಜಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಜಿ ಆರ್ ಇ ಜಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಜಿ ಐ TATED regurgitated is continuously regurgitated and swallowed repeatedly. Andre mel tagolodu nungodu tagolodu nungodu regurgitated repeatedly for around 240 times for around 240 times. ಆಯ್ತಾ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೆಪಾಸಿಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೂಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಕೂಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಚಕ್ಲಿ ತರ ಹಾಕತ್ತೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಬಾಯಿಂದ ವಾಂಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹಾಕತ್ತೆ ಕೂಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅನ್ರೈಪ್ ಹನಿ This is called unripe honey. It contains 80% water. ತುಂಬಾ ನೀರಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ. Unripe honey is converted to ripe honey. Unripe honey is converted into ripe honey through evaporation. Evaporation ಹೆಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ ನಾನು By fanning ಮೇಲೆ evaporation ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ Thus the ripe honey contain only 20% of honey. Thus the ripe honey contain only 20% of honey. Sorry, 20% of water. ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ನೀಟ್ಗೆ ಸಕ್ಕತ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸುಮಾರು ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನೀಟ್ ಅಷ್ಟರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೂ ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ವಿಚಿತ್ರವಾಗಿದೆ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಅಂತ ಅಲ್ವಾ and there are only 20% of water. Once honey get ripe, each comb cell is sealed. I repeat, ripe honey contain 20% of water. ಅದು ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಪ್ರಕೃತಿ ಅದೇನ ಬೇಕಾಗಿದ್ದು ನಿಮಗೆ ರೈಪ್ ಹನಿ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ 20% ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ನೋ ಓಕೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನ್ ಬರೀತೀರಾ ರೈಪ್ ಹನಿ ಈಸ್ ಸೀಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಕೂಂಬ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹಾಕಿ ಅಂದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಸೀಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತೇವೆ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡ್ತ ಸೀಲ್ ಇನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಕೂಂಬ್ ಸೆಲ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹನಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಲೆವಿಲೋಸ್ ಲೆವಿಲೋಸ್ So sugar, right? Levulose, 38%. Levulose, 38%. Dextrose, 21%. Maltose and other sugars, 8%. Enzymes and pigments, 2%. Water around 17%. I repeat, first let me finish. Water 17%. Vitamins A, B1, B2, B3, B6, C, E and K. I will repeat, first let me finish. Vitamins are A, B1, B2, B3, B6, C, E and K. Next, minerals, calcium, sodium, potassium, magnesium, iron, phosphorus, sulfur. I repeat all once again. First one, levulose sugar, levulose, 38%. I am repeating. Mat repeat madala. Second one, dextrose, 21%. 21%. Next, maltose and other sugars, 8%. Enzymes and pigments, 2%. Color it alone, dra honey color, brown color. Pigments, 2%. Water, 17%. 17 to 20 according. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಫುಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ರೈಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಹನಿಯಲ್ಲಿ 17 ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ 20% ಇರುತ್ತೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಟಮಿನ್ಸ್ ಎ B1 B2 B3 B6 CE ಅಂಡ್ ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಟಮಿನ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ರೇಂಜ್ ಇದೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಸಿಯಂ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಸಿಯಂ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಂ ಐರನ್ ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ All of you are written, this is very important composition of honey. Next, uses of honey. Note for all of you uses. Naale all of you in mukis pitti dini vatto. Naale animal breeding book kanda questions mara transcend inda. Vitamins and minerals are remaining the last year. Next two days, no 38 plus 21 plus 8 plus 2 plus 20. ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ಉಳಿದಿದ್ದೆಲ್ಲ ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೈಟಮಿನ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಷ್ಟು ಹಾಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು 100 ಮೈನಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಉಳಿದಿರೋದು ವಿಟಮಿನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಲಿಸನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಟುಡೇ ಐ ಫಿನಿಶ್ ದಿಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಹನಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಮೇಲೆ ನಾಳೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸೆಂಡ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಇಂದ ಓದೋಣ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈಟ್ನೆಸ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ವಲ್ಲ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ? ಇರಿ ಇರಿ, ಇದನ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ನಾನು ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ ಈಗ, ತುಂಬಾ ಬ್ರೈಟ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ತುಷಾರ್ ಯಾರಿದು? ತುಷಾರ್ ಹೂಸ್ ತುಷಾರ್? ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ, ಟುಡೇ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಲಿಸನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್. ಹೂಸ್ ತುಷಾರ್ ಬೇಬಿ? ಯಾರು ಬೇರೆಯವ್ರು ಗೊತ್ತಾವನು ತುಷಾರ್ ಯಾರಂತ? ಯಾವ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟ ನೀನು ತುಷಾರ್? ಯಾರ ವಿಚ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್? ನೀವು ಯಾವ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಅಪ್ಪ? ನೀವು ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಹೂ ಯು ಆರ್. ನನ್ ಬ್ರೈಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಅವಾಗೋಯ್ತು, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳಿ ಯಾರು ನೀನು? ಓಕೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆಮ್. ಸೊ ನಾಳೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ, ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಕೃತಿ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ಇಟ್. ಓಕೆ ರೈಟ್ ಆಮ್. ನೋ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಹನಿ ಆರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹನಿ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಇಟ್ ಕಂಟೇನ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ವೀಟ್ನರ್. ಇಟ್ ಕಂಟೇನ್ ಹೈ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಅಂತ ಬರೀ, ಹೈ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ವೀಟ್ನರ್. ಇಲ್ಲ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಗೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಲ್ವಾ ಹನಿನ, ಅದು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ಹನಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲೋರಿಕ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಡಿಯರ್ ಪ್ರಕೃತಿ, ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್, ಹನಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಹೈ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ವೀಟ್ನರ್. ಸಕ್ಕರೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ, ಆಯ್ತಾ? ನಂಬರ್ ಟೂ, ಹನಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಹೈ ಕ್ಯಾಲೋರಿಫಿಕ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಕ್ಯಾಲೋರಿಫಿಕ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಒನ್ ಕೆಜಿ ಆಫ್ ಹನಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ 3,350 ಕ್ಯಾಲೋರೀಸ್. ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಅಂದ್ರೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಒಂದ್ ಕೆಜಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ನೀವು ಒಂದ್ ಲೀಟರ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಕುಡಿದ್ರೆ 350 ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ, 310 ಕ್ಯಾಲರೀಸ್. ಒಂದ್ ಲೀಟರ್ ಫುಲ್ ಹಾಲು ಕುಡಿದ್ರು 310 ಕ್ಯಾಲರೀಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಒಂದ್ ಕೆಜಿ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು ತಿನ್ನಲ್ಲ ಒಂದ್ ಕೆಜಿ? ಒಂದ್ ಕೆಜಿ ನಲ್ಲಿ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ 3,350 ಕ್ಯಾಲರೀಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಮೆನಿ ಅಥ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಹನಿ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಗೇಮ್ಸ್. ಮೆನಿ ಅಥ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಹನಿ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಗೇಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಇವೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಇವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ರೀಸ್ಟೋರ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ರೀಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಧ್ಯ ಮಧ್ಯ ಸುಸ್ತಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹನಿ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪೂನ್ ಕುಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ರೀಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಇನ್ ಆಯುರ್ವೇದ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಹನಿ to children and elderly people, to children and elderly people to get strength quickly. ಬೇಗ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬರ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಹನಿ ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ದೊಡ್ಡವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಆಯುರ್ವೇದದಲ್ಲಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಹನಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಟು ಹೀಲ್ ದ ವೂಂಡ್ಸ್. Honey helps to heal the wounds. It's a good tonic for stomach ulcers. ಗುಳಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆದ್ರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹನಿ ಅಂತ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡಿ. ಸ್ಟಮಕ್ ಅಲ್ಸರ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಡೈಜೆಷನ್, ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಅಪಟೈಟ್. Improve appetite. Next, bee wax. Bee wax
It is produced by the abdominal glands of bees. It is produced by the abdominal glands of bees. ಯಾರು ಇದು ಬಿಟ್ಟದ್ದು ಹುಷಾರು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಹುಡುಗನೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾವ್ ಯಾರು ಯಾರು ಹೇಳಿ ಅವ್ನು ಯಾರು ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಓಡಿಸೋಣ ಅವನ್ನ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೂಂಬ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೂಂಬ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎನ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋಯಿಶ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ insoluble in water is used for preparation of paints varnishes preparation of paints varnishes candles and also as the ground substance and also as the ground substance in preparation of creams and ointments yes ಈಗ ಬ್ರೈಟ್ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಕ್ರೀಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಯಿಂಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ವೆನಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ರೀಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಪಾಯ್ಸನ್ ಗ್ಲಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ It is used as a curative toxin in humans. It is used as a remedy for rheumatoid arthritis. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಾಲಿಗೆ ಅರ್ಥರೈಟಿಸ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಹಚ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಯಾವುದು ವೆನಮ್ ರೂಮಟೈಡ್ ಅರ್ಥರೈಟಿಸ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಕಂಜಂಕ್ಟಿವೈಟಿಸ್ ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಕಣ್ಣು ರೆಡ್ ಆಗತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಕಣ್ಣು ಬೇನೆ ಬರ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಕಂಜಂಕ್ಟಿವೈಟಿಸ್ and inflammation of the eye kannu uri bandaga adana akota venom not honey it is applied in the skin during skin diseases it is applied on the skin to cure skin diseases By treatment of venom, the cholesterol level decreases in the blood. The use of venom, cholesterol level decreases in the blood. Next, it decreases blood pressure. It decreases blood pressure. ಅರ್ಥಾಯ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಈ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ದು ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಬ್ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಒಳ್ಳಿತು ನಾಳೆ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಬ್ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಇದೆ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ
ट्रांसेंट बुक तो बड़े अल्ला क्वेश्चन सॉल्व माना इज इट फाइन
वैक्सिंग ना मैम ना मैम ये नहीं वैक्सिंग है मैं वैक्सिंग है वैक्स आज बना ओके फाइन ना ट्रांसेंट विचार बनाना बुद्ध करना नहीं वो सॉल्व मार दिया लार ट्रांसेंट का ऑलमोस्ट वी आर डन एवरीथिंग व्हिचएवर इज नॉट डन आई विल अगेन एक्सप्लेन टू यू ओके See you then. Bye-bye.